What is up, guys, and welcome back to the channel. So I'm feeling all very Christmassy just now. I'm in like my vlogging corner of my office, and there's a game that is coming out very soon, and I expect this video to probably have like a high ratio of dislikes. Hopefully not because of me, but it's a game that's not even out yet, and already it's going to be causing a little bit of a stir. And while I appreciate the fact that most people probably clicked on this video to be like, oh, that game, brr, I do understand. I'm a huge Metal Gear Solid fan. I've played all of them except for the third one. I don't know why I never played the third one, but I've played all the Metal Gear Solid games. I absolutely love them. It's one of my all-time favorite franchises. Don't know what is wrong with my words tonight. I'm obviously just very tired. Let's be honest for a second here. Metal Gear Solid 5 could have been a masterpiece. I do love that game, but due to some of the drama that was going on behind the scenes, it definitely got ruined, I would say, leaving a lot of us kind of confused and very upset. And of course, we know that, well, I at least think we know that there's not going to be any more Metal Gear Solid games, but there is a game coming out called Metal Gear Survive. Ugh. Now, I'm probably going to play this game more out of curiosity than anything, but the point of this video is to kind of talk about the Metal Gear Solid situation, and there is some new gameplay that has come out today, so I want to watch that just now, in before Konami strikes the video, of course. So I've got it up on my phone, Last Guardian phone cover. Trico, so cute. So let's go ahead and watch it together, and then we can obviously talk about it and things like that. There's a lot of people already saying that it's just, they don't want to touch it, you know, out of the principle of Metal Gear Solid, keeping that franchise alive. But yeah, I don't know what to expect from it myself, so let's just dig in and watch it.
Peggy 16.
はい、こんにちは、メタルギアサバイブプロデューサーのコレカドです。本日は、皆様に、メタルギアサバイブのシングルプレイについて紹介したいと思います。メタルギアサバイブはですね、メタルギアソリッド5、MGS5 のスピンオフゲームです。MGS5 で好評だったゲームシステムやアクション性を生かして、サバイバル要素の強いストーリーモードであるシングルプレイ、そして仲間と共にですね、迎撃ユニットや防衛ユニットを自由に配置して、戦う戦略性の強いコーププレイ、2つのモードがあります。これからはシングルプレイの基本的なアクション、そしてゲームの流れについてと、プレイヤーにとってシングルプレイ、コーププレイともに重要な活動拠点となるベースキャンプについてご紹介したいと思います。サバイブのストーリーは
Survive Story is not directly tied to Metal Gear Solid 5.This is an apocryphal story set apart from the main Metal Gear Solid timeline, just like the submissions in Ground Zeroes that feature Raiden or Snake from Metal Gear Solid 1. The story in Metal Gear Survive starts with the Mother Base assault by XOF at the end of Metal Gear Solid 5, Ground Zeroes. The main character is one of the soldiers that was fighting on Mother Base. Just when the Mother Base started to collapse,A wormhole appeared in the sky and sucked in debris, corpses, and soldiers that were still alive. Our protagonist managed to escape this fate. 6 months later, the player is sent by a mysterious organization through the wormhole to an alternate world. In this world, the player first arrives at base camp, set near a wrecked mother base. Food and water are still essential resources needed to survive.A small number of animals can be found here, which you can hunt for food. Crafting is also very important when you prepare for missions. A lot of materials can be found throughout the world that are useful for crafting. You can collect them and bring them back to base camp. Crafting objects requires materials and recipes.You can come up with your own recipes when it comes to cooking, but for powerful items and weapons, you need to get the recipes as rewards in multiplayer. Firearms are very powerful, but ammunition is a scarce resource, so use them wisely. There are a lot of melee weapons in Metal Gear Survive. Every weapon has unique characteristics, so you can choose one according to the combat situation, or just use your favorite. Now we've collected enough materials to craft an oxygen tank. Base camp is enshrouded by a poisonous mist, so we need an oxygen tank to enter this mist. If the oxygen level drops to zero, it's certain death. We need to keep an eye on its levels.
You're nearly out of oxygen.
The story progresses by clearing the main missions. Optional side missions are also available. Both main missions and side missions that are available are displayed on the map. Items, materials, and even people from different places and times are randomly teleported to this world from time to time. It's important for the player to collect materials as they are progressing on their mission. Let's explore the surroundings while being careful of wanderers. If you get spotted by a wanderer, it will call others and attack in force. I recommend you sneak behind the creature's back or kill it with a silent weapon, such as a bow. You can only carry a limited number of arrows, but fortunately, you can pick up the ones you fired. Containers will give you precious items and recipes. You can destroy them to get the items faster, but you can also take more time and open them silently. We found a female survivor. She's still alive. Let's hurry to bring her back to base camp.
Thank you.
The materials you collect are not only used for crafting, but also for strengthening the base camp's defenses. You can build many types of facilities in your base camp. You can farm crops, build water tanks, or facilities to develop better items and weapons. Furthermore, you never know when the wanderers will attack your base camp. You have to be prepared for it at any time. Don't forget to set your defenses. People you've saved will join your crew. By assigning them to the right team, you'll be able to develop your camp further and faster. One of the most unique features of this game is that you can also place the defensive units or interceptor units wherever you want. There are many ways to face the same situation. Where to place the units and what weapons to use is totally up to the players and their strategies. In co-op mode, players may encounter strong enemies or hordes that cannot be fought alone. Cooperate with your teammates to take them down. All the weapons and items are common to both single player and co-op multiplayer. Players can use materials collected in the campaign and rewards earned in co-op to further develop base camp, reinforce weapons and items, and beat the hardest missions.
はい、いかがでしたでしょうか。シングルプレイの基本的なゲームの流れやアクションについて、少しでありますがご理解いただけたのではないでしょうか。これまでメタルギアシリーズはメタルギアオンラインのように本編のシステムを使って本編とは違う遊びを提供してきました。メタルギアサバイブは MGS5 で好評だったゲームシステム、アクション性を生かしてサバイバル、コープといったゲーム性を加えることで新しい遊びを皆様にお届けしたいと思っています。最後になりますが、来年の1月オープンベータを開始する予定です。皆様もぜひご自身の手でメタルギアサバイブのゲームプレイを体験してみていただけないでしょうか。本日はどうもありがとうございました。
Oh, that's cool. So there's a beta. I was looking up there. I don't know why you guys are here, not up there. Alright, so that is the brand new trailer that we have obviously just watched from Metal Gear Survive. So that's the first time I've watched that, for the record. It's very State of Decay.It's kind of strange actually, because State of Decay 2 is coming out in 2018, and now we've got Metal Gear Survive coming out in 2018. But I don't know, it seems like Metal Gear Survive has taken a lot of inspiration from games like State of Decay, and I just, maybe if they took the Metal Gear off of it, then people might actually appreciate that as being a pretty solid crafting game. But it's just the fact that.There's been so much drama with Konami and Metal Gear and obviously Kojima and things like that, that I just think that Metal Gear Survive, like, it's already, it's like the umbrella core, do you know what I mean? we all remember Umbrella Corps and just how bad that turned out to be for Capcom, and I definitely feel like that's probably going to happen with Metal Gear Survive. I do like that it's got kind of a story basing after Metal Gear Solid 5, although kind of feel like, you know, maybe you should have just done some DLCs instead for Metal Gear Solid 5 so that we could have got the finish that we deserved for the Metal Gear Solid franchise. But hey, I'm gonna try and not get into that argument because it's, you know, still burns me inside, the fact that, like, there was so much happening at the end of Metal Gear Solid 5, like with Sirlanthropus, such a name, and obviously Liquid when he was younger and things like that. But as I say, that's like an entirely different topic that I could talk about for hours on end. I'll definitely try out the beta coming in January. It's something that I really enjoyed, the Metal Gear Solid 5 online when that eventually came. So part of me is seeing a lot of similarities between Metal Gear Solid Online and Survive. I just don't understand the enemies. I don't understand the universe. But then I suppose at this point, we're not supposed to understand. We don't have the story behind us. But it just seems like a really strange project for Konami to do. But the point is, I don't know if I'm hyped for it or not. I have no idea. But I am intrigued by it and I'm very interested by it. So, but now I want to take to you guys and I want to know what you guys think about it. And obviously try and be considerate on this video. The only reason I say that is because I've seen a lot of other people doing videos about this game in particular, and their videos have been getting like a lot of abuse and whatnot, so there's no need for that on this video. Let's all just try and have like a nice discussion about it, and I want to know what your guys' thoughts and feelings on Metal Gear Survive are, and maybe Metal Gear Solid 5 as well, because I love talking about that game. It was really good for what it was. So yeah, this has been Metal Gear Survive, just me wanting to talk to you guys about it coming. I will play the beta in January, and I hope you guys have an amazing rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye!